Whakatau mai rā, koutou ngā mātou, whakaputa no e te awe. Tēnei hoki rā, te rā whakanui ana koutou, kua tei ki te taumata, teitei a te mātou ranga e. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā rā koutou.
Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoi fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, University staff, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of the council members and staff of the university. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will confer diplomas and award degrees in the Faculty of Business and Economics. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated that the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million. Your university experience and the qualification gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Business and Economics, we have seen several notable achievements in the last year. Mike Lee was chosen as an outstanding reviewer for Asia Pacific Journal of Marketing and Logistics in the 2015 Emerald Literati Network Awards for Excellence. Catherine Frethy-Bentham was inducted as a fellow by the Research Association of New Zealand. A team of four Auckland business students won first place in the Chula Lungkorn International Business Case Competition in Thailand. These teams were asked to provide growth strategies for medical tourism at a Thai destination. Dr. Laszlo Sachas was elected president of the Australia-New Zealand Marketing Academy for a three-year term, and Professor Norman Wong was made a fellow of the Chartered Accountants of Australia and New Zealand. In order to ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, the university must do three things, in my opinion. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, I believe we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements I've just described. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. So it is no coincidence that in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in New Zealand in 35 of the 40 ranked subjects. We don't even teach two of them. So if we just think about that achievement for a moment, the 40 ranked subjects, we teach 38, and we were ranked top in 35. It sounds like an outstanding result to me. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program so as to ensure that we do provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with a first qualification, and you will rightly be proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for us all as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. So whatever path you follow, I urge you as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. But today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am pleased to welcome our guest speaker, Scott Perkins. Scott is an alumnus of this university, graduating with a Bachelor of Commerce and a Bachelor of Laws with honours. He has extensive Australasian and international experience as a corporate advisor. He was most recently head of corporate finance for Deutsche Bank Australia and New Zealand, and a member of the executive committee with overall responsibility for the bank's activities in this region. He was also a member of the Asia Pacific Corporate and Investment Bank Management Committee, and before that he was Chief Executive Officer of Deutsche Bank New Zealand and Deputy Chief Executive of Bankers Trust New Zealand. Scott's experience encompasses advising leading local and international companies across a broad range of markets on strategy, mergers and acquisitions, and capital markets matters. He's the non-executive director of Woolworths Limited, Brambles Limited, and he was a founding director of Meridian Energy. Scott is an active participant in the not-for-profit communities in Australia and New Zealand and has a long-standing commitment to breast cancer, the visual arts, and public policy development. Among his many activities, he co-founded Sweet Louise, which helps women with breast cancer live positive lives, was the founding director of the public policy think tank, the New Zealand Initiative, and a director of the Museum of Contemporary Art in Sydney. He served the university as a director of UniServices, our research commercialised company, for 14 years, and will, at the conclusion of this ceremony, be honoured as a fellow of the University of Auckland. Please join with me in welcoming Scott Perkins.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the Council, members of the University, graduands, families and friends, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. I first want to congratulate you all on achieving this milestone. You should be proud of having navigated successfully these university years. They are great times, a real journey of discovery, discovering adulthood and shedding adolescence, discovering competition for grades, for jobs, for attention, discovering the basis for new friendships outside of old school or neighbourhood or family links, discovering the reality of constant change, discovering that unlike your parents' world, your world is much flatter, closer, bigger, where the opportunities are broader, more unpredictable, more specialised, and less secure. Discovering what it means to budget and the real world pressure of cash flow. Discovering that as you reflect on how you got right here today, how many people have played a pivotal role in getting you here. Your parents, your wider family, mentors, the anonymous benefactors who have funded scholarships and prizes to give you a chance at a bright future. Starting to discover what it means to be a citizen, with opportunities to have a point of view on your society. The bigness of thinking to give back, not just the ambitious recipient of that most precious public good, a great education. So the good news is you have made it. The bad news is you haven't. University, and in particular this university, is a fabulous ticket to the game. Whether you reach your full potential, in my experience, is a function of whether you master a bunch of complementary life skills that were not part of your core curriculum, that are best and only learned on the job of life post-graduation. You won't have really learned what it takes to convince people of your point of view. You probably won't have learned how to balance in the job context your competitive instincts with your collaborative instincts. You won't have learned how to truly see the world through the eyes of your customers, your clients, your colleagues. You won't have felt the searing disappointment of professional setback or the unfairness of a fickle job market. You won't have had that moment of crushing self-awareness at the hands of a better product, a better price, a better salesperson. You won't have needed to stare down the temptation of very real short-term financial gain in favour of doing the right thing for the longer term. You won't have learned how to nicely disassemble your boss's perspective without them feeling that you're in fact saying that he or she is a complete idiot. You won't have needed to navigate adeptly the office politics that stand in the way of career progression. You may not have experienced the unpredictable joy of applying your skills to those who are less fortunate than yourselves. You won't have sensed the exhilaration of it all coming together, the ka-ching of reward of any sort, which would enable you, of course, to attend to your student loan as a first priority. These new skills needed to reach your full potential in life, in my experience, fit into three buckets: ethics, empathy, and energy. On ethics, it's pretty simple. Without a clear moral compass, you are lost. Without a reflex to do the right thing, you will be degraded and become less valuable to others and to yourself. Without building a track record of forthright honesty, you will be passed over. Without standing up and calling out, you will limit your potential. And eventually, you get found out. You should know that all the very, very smart people who work with you and for whom you work have very acute olfactory ethical senses. And please do not assume these choices will be easy. Our society is full of instances where the old ways of doing things, put under the new spotlights of transparency and scrutiny, are shown up to fall short. You will be placed in very tricky circumstances where you may have much to lose. But treasure your reputation. Avoid actively those who don't pass your ethical smell test. Invariably, your gut feel is right. Be assertive in staking out your own reputational boundaries and sleep well at night. But of course, there are many truly good people who never make it out of the slow lane. Goodness is not the ticket to greatness. It is necessary, but it is not sufficient. So why would empathy be any more important an ingredient? For all those graduates today who have outstanding marks but poor EQ, and who are sitting next to great communicators who have okay marks, the playing field is about to be leveled. Empathy. The experience of understanding another person's position from their perspective is all too rare a talent, but it is learnable. It is the key that can unlock your true abilities. Seeing the world only through your own eyes and not being able to demolish your own argument, not being brave enough to concede the better point of view, in public, not having the humility or the patience to listen to others, your colleagues, your customers, your boss, and truly balance up the arguments, to me is more than anything else going to be the choke point in your career. You are all intelligent, but are you clever? Invariably, those with distinctive customer empathy, client empathy, team member empathy, societal empathy, will see their careers accelerate. Those determined to be the cleverest in the room, but who don't read the furrowed eyebrow of their colleagues, who don't sense the loss of attention in the eyes of their customers, who needlessly offend through lack of awareness, they fail to build trust. They fail to bring out the best in others. They fail to become bigger than their own constraints over time. Please see the world through other people's eyes. But sadly, there are many good people with plenty of empathy who also never make it to the fast lane. Here is where a deep breath is needed. If I look back on my career, my relationships, my finances, nothing has been easy. The golden footballs simply don't exist. So the good people with great empathy who don't have the energy, the utter tenacity to pick themselves up after failure, to believe in themselves when others don't, who will withstand the headwinds of prejudice or short-sightedness or dim-wittedness that abounds out there, they will fail to reach their full potential. It takes practice, failure, more practice, more risk-taking, more self-awareness, more learning, and then all of that over again. To reach that sweet point of success, where one permits oneself that sense of mastery, the overwhelming calmness of knowing that you did everything you could, and the peace of whatever outcome that is. So if you have the ethics, the empathy, and the energy, I am confident you will do this degree, this university, your family, your friends who have invested so much in you, the true justice of your full potential. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Scott, for a most insightful and challenging address. Would you please join with me in thanking Scott once again? This is a meeting of Council in Convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Business and Economics have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Associate Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Mrs. Lawrenson, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics, to the degree of Bachelor of Business and Information Management, Mizhard Freddie Baum. Emma Jane Burrows. Richard Chandra. Rebecca Vern Pincher. James Robert Easton. Ajay Gargi. Yifan Guo. Scott Andrew Robert Hitchens. Kieran Lee Han Liu. Yan Chun Lin. Tamara Sarek. Pari Tarapore. Joss Alexander Toka. Madoka Karen Yamamoto. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Siti Nur Natasha Binti Abdullah Sahari. Nicole Rosalie Ramos Alzaz. Hezron Alban. Abdullah Al Damili. Reem Al Hilali. Sara Mukhtar Ali. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Jared Matthew Allen. Fernanda Alvarez de Lugo Colmenares. Raymond Amora. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Courtney Jordan Indella. Simon David Anderson. Julie Ann Alones Oniko. Arisha Akil. Joshua James Arona. Andrew Joseph Everson. Sohi Beck. Jonathan Stanley Baker. Peter Beltotsky. Christy Chanel Bertenshaw. Chitresh Mahesh Bhagwan. Neil B. Bula. Christina Vivian Bilkey. Rachel Marie Blackwell. Nicola Jane Blockley. Samuel Christopher Blood. Carl Heinz Bode. Isabel Grace Bosher. Lucy Rosalind Branken. Laura Holly Brash. Jack Norman Alfred Britlin Whiting. Alexander Graham Brunton. Benjamin James Raphael Butt. Yulin Kai. Yang Kiao. Yi Ching Chiao. Amy Rose Chan. Henry Hong Lup Chan. Hock Lim Chan. Michelle Chan. Pui San Simon Chan. Yinglam Kelly Chan. Shravil Aman Chandra. Sika Chaturvedi. Hui Yu Julia Chow. Mei Li Chi. Taoran Chen. Wanjin Chen. Yongxi Chen. Jacai Chong. Matthew Jared Chesham. Soventara Kim Chiv. Wonhee Young Choi. Natasha Hui Mei Chong. Suzanne Chong. Rachel Xiao Tuan Chai. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Stephanie Grace Choi. Hannah Tua. Sol Chun. Lita Gillian Chun Yu. Emma Victoria Clark. Anna Ann Cohen. Kimberly Marie Connolly. Simon Neil Connolly. Daniel Joshua Corbett. Timothy James Gordon Cotton. Jessica Ann Crew Brown. Jonathan Timothy Croucher. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Yusuf Dada. Gashing Dai. Maria Damien. Sophia Dow. Stephen William Day. Bhavik Bipin Daya. Shanuk Denzel Philip De Silva. J. Jacob Antonio De Souza. Vipul Dev. Brendan Thomas Devoy. Hamod Danda. Kanupriya Dewan. Don Mandung. Emma Victoria Dorset. Ivan Dropalich. Jocelyn Marcel D'Souza. Michael Lafras Duplessis. Maria Andreevna Dunaskaya. Theodore Edward Michael Duncan. Elena Duransky. Hayden Hunter Eldridge. Christelle Engelbrecht. Lillian Falcon Jimenez. Samuel William Steiner Fastia. Braden Yu Fing Ling Feng. Emma Louise Fermor. Ek Champo Liji Sashini Shihara Fernando. Rachel Susan Kate Ferris. Kais Karam Fidai. Sarah Phil. Max O'Brien Fitzgerald. Michael Pikitiora Fitzpatrick. Belinda Chiu Fong. Melanie Jean Foote. Cheryl Leilani Latafele Fruin. Wan Ching Fu. Ruth Sharon Galvin. Janissa Gunn. Gan Yi Zheng. Jihan Ganjia. Min Gao. Peter Harrison Gardner. Emma Jean Celia Mary Gibson. Amanpreet Singh Gill. Praveen Giritharan. Jordan Michelle Gleason. Chong Jing Go. Harold Chu Ming Go. Chandrani Divya Gunda. Roshan Govin. Shui Gu. Dion Simon Guest. Jasa Kanave Giamelon. Han Yu Go. John Hung Min Ha. Zhu Hun Han. Samuel Mark Hand. Gladi Rosa Hanipale. Anna Louise Harding. Martin Richard Anton Harnett. Angus Edward Harris. Jasper Rudy Minglin Hatono Zen. Braden Rodney Harwood. Stacey Margaret Harwood. Joshua Stephen Hawkey. Alexandria Helen Haynes. Li Ying He. Shi Chen He. Xian Lei He. Nikki Naldine Hershap. Benjamin Wilhelm Hendricks. Yung Jai He. Jasmine A.R. Higgins. Sarah Jane Higgins. Douglas Michael Hillier. Hinjing Ho. Alisa Adele Hoffman. Benjamin William Holloway. Alison Liz Hong. Anthony Charles Hopper. Lucy Alice Horner. David John Howells. Ming Yu Hu. Lei Huang. Rebecca Rachel Hughes. Mu Gi Wonders Way. Florence Erlitas Hulley. Laura Jane Hunt. Esalarasi Alango. Michael Novena Ioani. Davida Rohemara Yosefa. Daniel and Jean Yotwa. Fabian Y. Chunip. Haley Robin Isaacson Hansen. Helena Maria Jean Jacobs Jackson. Jessica Marie Jackson. Edward Adrian Derek James. Fergus Douglas James. Kimberly Sarah James. Daniel Mark Jess Person. Jingji. Yon Duk Jun. Elizabeth Siok Yun Jung. Yang Chen Kang. Yu Chong Kang. Bhavneet Kaur. Daisy Kaur. Meera Ambika Kaushik. Mitchell Henry Kelly. Timothy Raymond Kemp. Matthew Charles Kenwood. Tashvin Tayyum Khan. Raymond Coe. Trisha Kurana. Michael Kuwatanasene. Giyu Hee Kim. Yun Hee Kim. John Kyung Kim. Myung Ji Kim. Son Min Kim. Su In Kim. Su Yun Kim. Stephen Kim. Su Young Kim. Young Kyun Kim. Ryan Peter King. Mariana Sherelle Uhini Kingi. Madison Margaret Kinney. Michael John Kitching. Rachel Helen Knight. Benjamin Ji Jiang Ko. Sri Raghu Vumshi Koyil Kundadai. Ling Yang Kong. Sarah Ku. Pei Yi Kua. Manami Kubara. Ningwei Kuo. Rory Patrick Valchvik. Karen Kwan Ying Kwok. Yun Zik Kwong. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint. Rajesh Shari Booker. And a Bachelor of Arts. Christian Milan Barbaric and a Bachelor of Science. Kalpesh Ramesh Bhagwan and a Bachelor of Science. Simran Bhatti and a Bachelor of Arts. Nicholas Michael Bird, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Engineering Science. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Lauren Rachel Bowler, and a Bachelor of Science. Thomas Khan Brash, and a Bachelor of Laws. Isaac William Buxton Breeley, and a Bachelor of Science. Christopher James Bond, and a Bachelor of Property. Logan Graham Burgess, and a Bachelor of Science. Yibo Kai, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division in Mechanical Engineering. Martin Gabriel Ildama Camacho, and a Bachelor of Arts. Jamie Ewan Cameron, and a Bachelor of Property. Bobby Kunsun Chan, and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, and Senior Scholar Science, Jessica Ann Channings, and a Bachelor of Science. Michael Sven Schalzund, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ho Yen Chen, and a Bachelor of Science. Yi Young Chen, and a Bachelor of Engineering. Jonathan Yan Lam Cheng, and a Bachelor of Arts. Vincent Kok Ping Chia, and a Bachelor of Science. Agnes Sung Hui Chin, and a Bachelor of Laws. Jessica Ashley Choi, and a Bachelor of Science. Vera Putiputi Clarkson, and a Bachelor of Science. John Michael Decaney, and a Bachelor of Arts. Melody Krista Damawan, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours, with First Class Honours in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Siddharth Dave, and a Bachelor of Science. Simon Winston Davies, and a Bachelor of Science. Osman Yasser Demirbas, and a Bachelor of Arts. Ashley Kayla Donald Boosey, and a Bachelor of Arts. Caitlin Draper Wheeler, and a Bachelor of Arts.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of the ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Joella Pinto on violin will now perform Scherzo Tarantella by Henrik Beniowski.
Thank you.
Thank you, Joella, for that stunning performance. Ladies and gentlemen, please join with me in thanking Joella once more. If you would like to hear more from our wonderful young musicians, I invite you to attend the Graduation Concerto Gala Competition to be held in the Town Hall on Thursday, 12th of May at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Whitred, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, Rachel Louise Elizabeth Erica, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Jennifer Fennick, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sasha Sakura Finlay, and a Bachelor of Arts. Alexander Campbell Fergie, and a Bachelor of Arts. Nadine Leanna Wongfoy, and a Bachelor of Arts. Janie Claire Fryer, and a Bachelor of Arts. Xiao Wen Gun, and a Bachelor of Science. Yun Gao, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Mechanical Engineering. Francesca Go Xin Yi, and a Bachelor of Arts. Emma Marie Hardy, and a Bachelor of Arts. Yi Lin He, and a Bachelor of Science. Simon Matthew Healy, and a Bachelor of Property. Sarah Elizabeth Louise Heffer, and a Bachelor of Arts. Courtney Francis Henderson, and a Bachelor of Arts. Sophia Huang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel Richard Hoskins, and a Bachelor of Property. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Robert Yuan Ho, and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with First Class Honours in Engineering Science. Samuel John Holt, and a Bachelor of Arts. Yi Lin Huang, and a Bachelor of Arts. Xu Jun Hughes, and a Bachelor of Arts. Emma Dawn Jobe, and a Bachelor of Arts. Tala Marie Eliza Johnston, and a Bachelor of Arts. Postgraduate Diploma in Business. Matthew William Grant Abbott in Administration. Fleur Armstrong in Administration. John Andrew Ashley in Administration. Melissa Faye Axelrad in Administration. Priscilla Viotto Bernardes in Administration. Christopher John Bray in Administration. Monica Ann Burbidge in Administration. Andrew Gordon Brown in Administration. William Robert Brown in Administration. Helen Alice Burt in Administration. Philip Terence Callahan in Administration. Hadass Kami Thompson in Administration. Jodine Juanita Clark in Administration. Bartholomeus Stephanus Diederichs in Administration. Donald Bruce Edwards in Administration. John Christopher Anthony Faitala in Administration. Brendan Thomas Hickman in Administration. Daniel Pico Rangi Hook in Administration. Jacob Daniel Horan in Administration. Simon Kenneth Hunt in Administration. Gabrielle Ann Knight in Administration. Peter Gordon Lamont in Administration. Fa'amanu Ma'ava in Administration. Vika Ma'inu Fasavalu in Administration. Francis Paula Mayadeo in Administration. Amanda Jane Millar in Administration. Luke Douglas Muschin in Administration. Robert Simon Reed in Administration. Alison Grace Rocky in Administration. Balpreet Singh in Administration. Dilpreet Kushdev Singh in Administration. Felicity Isabel Jane Wiggins in Administration. Michael James Wood in Administration. Nathaniel Lee Balisasa Yali Maiwai in Administration. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Nelson Taitai Annandale in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Brooke Liam Burrows McFarlane in Marketing. Caitlin Chelsea Patricia Davies in Economics. Claire Glenda Gawley in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. University Graduate Scholar Malika Hariharan in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Greer Holford in Marketing. Paula Angela Burgos Hontalba in Economics. Mohunthan Ishwaran in Finance. Kiran David Love Jans in Marketing. Parth Nilesh Kumar Joshi in Marketing. Andrea Kursi-Hui in International Business. Alex Francis Kirkpatrick in Economics. Donna Kwong Kwong Lam in Marketing. Kit Hui Leo in Information Systems. Johnson Liu in Marketing. Wai Na Mak in Economics. Daniel Trong Duc Nguyen in Accounting. Xuan Khan Nguyen in Information Systems. Kyu Jin Park in Information Systems and a Bachelor of Commerce. Danielle Elise Pattenden in Management. Zoe Page Pushon in Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Edward James Robertson in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Meng Meng Chan in Accounting. Matthew David Shaw in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Alexandra Ann Todd in Management. Linda Minghu Tran in Economics. University Graduate Scholar Hong Chuan Wong in Economics. Chen Yuan Wong in Finance. Alex Yuan in Economics. Jingyuan Zhuang in Accounting. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Molly Rebecca Benson in Economics. Rima Chawala in Information Systems. Jiwon Jot Kua Chima in International Business. David Sheng Chin Chen in Finance. Emily Chu Han Go in Information Systems. Tan Hua in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Jasmine Alexandra Lindsay in Management. Daniel John Murphy in Management. Thea Nika in International Business. Visawa Sabai Muang in Accounting. Mariam Taufik Salah in Operations and Supply Chain Management. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Tasha Jia Yun Go in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Min Lee in Marketing. Adele Kathleen Wright St. Clair in Commercial Law. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours, Jo Lee Hu Tong Wong in Management. To the degree of Master of Business Administration, Mahmoud Sayed Mohammed Abu Taleb. Michael Bernard Pavey Auckland. Simon Bainbridge. Paul Robert Blue. Zachary David Burt. Gerard Andrew Hosum Casey. Danny Sinyao Chai. Charlie Yuning Chen. Chun Ho Samson Chung. Mackenzie Collis. Ross Nicholas Copeland. David Lang Elder. Graham John Gallagher. And a postgraduate diploma in business administration. Craig Allen Gillette. Tanya Lynn Harvey. Grant Stevenson Henderson. Robert John Hunt. Mark Leonard Kaneko. Heather Dawn Mary Kelly. Suman Kumar Sashi Dananda Murthy Karidi. Chia Urku. Arjanis Lal. Gordon Robert Law. Mary Tisiola Lause. Matthew Leonard Maligan. Fiona Catherine Michelle. Brenda Mary Milbank. Anthony David Mills. Alistair James Graham Monk, and a postgraduate diploma in business administration. David John Carroll Morris. Taran Leanne Muir. Lisa Jane Norton. Jeffrey Brian Oakes. Daniel John Oliver. Adam Bruce Petten. Neil Punger. Alistair John Rackham. Michael Peter Rendell. Emma Frances Southwood. Sean Peter Stowers. William Vincent Thomas Tracy. Zinat Vazir. Matthew Anthony Vox. Wayne Carl Wilkie. Melanie Catherine Holly Wilson. Joanne Wright. Seung Hoon New and a postgraduate diploma in business administration. Xiao Si Yu. To the degree of Master of Commercialization and Entrepreneurship, Craig Matthew Carpenter. Berger Victor Paula Dyricks. Bruce William Douglas. Nicholas Stewart Glanfield. Nicholas Marlowe Hodson. Robert Jonathan Holmes. Y. Kent Lee. Hilary Ann Lewis. Xu Jing Lee. Tahir Ahmed Mohammed Zafarella. Maheen Dumithar Mudonaika. Nitin Prasad. Jason Philip Ranston. Dion James Shepherd. Rupak Sinha. Justin Paul Sweetman. Ning Zhu. To the degree of Master of Management, Avishta Belas. Giles Rupert Hartley Cox. Mingfei Duan. Ji Geng. Minyan He. Ziyan He. Jen Chao Chia. Vaisinia Rose of Sharon Murphy. Yuta Mickey. Xiang Ni. Mengxia Qin. Kong Shen. Yu Qi Shen. Yuxin Su. Sutan Subarayala. Dongfang Wong. Jung Robin Wong. Lu Wong. Yu Qian Wong. Fan Xu. Wei Xuan. Ke Yan. Mu Chan Yang. Si Yuan Yang. Jun Tao Yue. Shuo Fun Zhang. Wen Wen Zhao. Xiao Fan Zhou. Ying Zhou. Bowen Zhu. To the degree of Master of Professional Accounting, Ai Zhu. Reina Bano. Jing Chai. Juliana Sui Su Chan. Jia Di Ding. Yu Jie Fan. Jing Wing Fong. Li Jia Fong. Jin Ju Fu. Zi Wen Hu. Justine Joseph. Kwang Won Kim. Jing Li. Mong Ying Li. Jen Jen Li. Yin Ru Liang. Ji Chuan Yong. Ru Jie Xi. Andrew Jack Stewart. Sun Yao. Yin Teng. Hui Wong. Xiao Tong Wong. Jiang Zhang. Xiao Zhang. Kan Zhou Jiao. Xiao Yu Zhou. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with First Class Honours, Michelle Robin Sinclair. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Connie Yuking Liu. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Selvendra Kuranesh Singh. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies, Muneeb Ahmed, and a graduate diploma in commerce.
what I was going to do. I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Xiaoyin Bai in Information Systems, and a postgraduate diploma in Commerce with merit in Information Systems, and a graduate diploma in Commerce. Bai designed and implemented purposeful visualisation systems that can be used to create purpose-driven, context-sensitive, stakeholder-relevant, adaptive visualisations. Her research helps people turn their data into visual stories that inform, engage, enchant, and empower, and eventually achieve better support for decision-making. Bye. Nina Brocious in Marketing, University Doctoral Scholar. Nina looked at how young consumers use familiar and unfamiliar branded products when living in a foreign country for a fixed period of time. Her work shows that certain branded products can provide connections to loved ones back home, while others may help with settling in and making friends in the new place of residence. Nina, congratulations. Yuwei Xu in Information Systems. Yuwei examined repurchase behaviours in online auctions in New Zealand and Taiwan, looking at how buyers' repurchase intentions influence their repurchase behaviours. Her study also examined how service provision moderates the relationship between repurchase intentions and repurchase behaviours. Yuwei, congratulations. Dusan Ku in Information Systems, University Doctoral Scholar. Container terminals play a pivotal role in completing global supply chains. Dusan studied the challenging problem of improving productivity in terminal logistics with little additional investment. His breakthrough research was on a double cycling strategy which enhances key crane utilisation. Theoretical insights, computational algorithms, and practical solution approaches were the highlights of Dusan's thesis. Dusan, congratulations. Grigory Jubinikal in International Business, University Doctoral Scholar. Grigory looked at how interdependencies influence competitive behaviour. Focusing on interdependencies in terms of loan and deposit markets, while taking into account idiosyncratic competitive circumstances, he analysed banking organisations operating in the United States of America in the 2000s. Grigory. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Business and Economics.
I now call upon the Chief Executive of Uni Services, Dr. Andy Schenk, to present a fellow of the University of Auckland.
Citation for the award of Fellow of the University of Auckland to Scott Redfors Perkins. Scott Perkins is a graduate of the University of Auckland. Having completed both a Bachelor of Laws with Honors and a Bachelor of Commerce in 1988. He has had a distinguished career in the international corporate finance sector, most recently as Deutsche Bank's head of corporate finance for Australia and New Zealand. Mr. Perkins continues to serve the business community in both countries through a variety of senior corporate governance roles. The award of a university fellowship recognizes the outstanding support Mr. Perkins has given to the university and its associated entities. Principal among these contributions is his 14 years of distinguished service as a member of the board of Auckland Uni Services Limited, the university's research and commercialization company, and now the leading organization of its type in Australasia. During that period, in which the company experienced initially rapid growth and then the challenges of reduced public and private sector investment in research following the global financial crisis, Mr. Perkins has been a key member of the board, leading many of the discussions around corporate strategy and financial management. As a corporate strategist, he is without parallel. Mr. Perkins has thus been an important advisor to both of the chief executives during that period, Drs. Peter Lee and myself, as well as to the board. And he has helped the board, the company, to build strategic external relationships on behalf of the board. He has been a key figure in the company's success and therefore in the success of the university's research endeavors. Mr. Perkins has also supported the university in its philanthropic activities. He has, since 2005, funded the Louise Perkins Prize in Art History, established in the memory of his late wife. The Louise Perkins Prize makes a great difference to the student recipients, many of whom have gone on to significant achievements in the arts sector, and also to the art history program in the Faculty of Arts. Importantly, the prize acknowledges the importance of arts at a time when much public policy is directed towards the sciences and economic development. Mr. Perkins has also supported the Vice Chancellor in building relationships with potential donors in New Zealand and Australia, and so contributed to the university's wider philanthropic activities. As universities around the world have been encouraged, some might say forced, to diversify their external relationships and revenue streams, the commercialization of research and development of philanthropic support have become critical to their success. Mr. Perkins has played a key role in supporting the university in both these activities, and so has helped to lay a strong foundation for the future well-being of his alma mater. He deserves our gratitude and our recognition. Chancellor, university fellowships are awarded to those who make a unique and valuable contribution to the university. Scott Perkins's contribution has undoubtedly been both unique and valuable. Accordingly, I have the honor of presenting him to you for the award of a University of Auckland Fellowship.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. while they are standing, it would be a good time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme.